and you have emphasized, which has been mislaid, left, or forgot. And you actually say emphasize implied, but in the statute it's not.
It's my emphasis.
Correct. And then you go on to say, under the circumstances expressed above, only logical conclusions to be reached that the Abrams family left or forgot about the gold certificates. Now, if that were true, that would render it lost property, not abandoned property.
Correct.
So when you conclude that Schaefer, as the finder of the property, became the owner, that's not exactly true because it wasn't abandoned, it was lost.
It was lost property.
Okay. And I believe you asked, or, I'm sorry, you were asked whether or not, in your opinion, personal property that was in the home at the time title passed from Lisa Linder as the administrator of her grandmother's estate to the entity formed by the Burkes. You indicated that it did not pass by way of deed.
It did not pass specifically by way of deed. That's correct.
But there's nothing to indicate that it didn't actually bypass by actual fact outside of deed.
That would be something you'd have to have testimony on to prove.
Okay, right. So as you already indicated, personal property can pass by way of an oral agreement. It's not necessary that you pass ownership or an ownership interest or a claim of right or whatever by way of writing such as a deed or contract or sale.
That is correct.
And sometimes oral agreements are, if there is no specific record of an oral agreement or if there's some question about it, sometimes just the behavior of the parties involved with respect to the property can give an indication as to what their intent is.
We always know that two parties frequently have different intent on what they are planning on doing. So an oral agreement is always a dangerous agreement because one party may think that they are doing one thing and the other party may think they are doing something else.
Absolutely, but then you can also look at how the parties are behaving with respect to the act in question.
That is correct. And as I previously testified, Mrs. Schaefer was told to get rid of the junk by Mrs. Linder.
Right, right. But when that title to the house passed, whatever oral agreement there was regarding property terminated along with Lisa Linder's interest in the house?
No, not necessarily.
Okay.
It would depend on what the oral agreement was.
Right.
I had agreements where they survived the passing of the real estate title.
Okay. What we know is that the contract sale called for the property to be left in ruinous condition.
That is correct.
Okay. What we know is that there may have been an agreement or a tolerance on the part of Ms. Linder that Keith Schaefer could retain certain items in the house.
I'm not sure I understand that question.
Would it help to have it right back?
Well, sure.
Okay, what we know is that there may have been an agreement or a tolerance on the part of Ms. Linder that Keith Schaefer could retain certain items in the house.
Well, as I previously indicated, the only thing I understood was that Ms. Linder told Mr. Schaefer to get rid of all the junk other than, and then the only thing I recall specifically was the Michael Jackson doll.
Right, but you didn't read Lisa Linder's statement to the police, correct?
I may have, but I don't recall.
So you don't recall any details of what you may have indicated was her thinking with regard to Mr. Schaefer?
No.
That's all I have. And then the cross-examination by Mr. Fagen. Was there anything in any deed or contract from Abrams to Palmer indicating any transfer of the safe?
I didn't see anything in any of the testimony that I read or reviewed.
So is it fair to say that the only time there was any knowledge from what you reviewed of a safe was when Schaefer located same. Would that be fair to say?
Correct.
I don't have any further questions. And then we have redirect by Mr. Benedict. The prosecutor asked you whether or not you had any knowledge of the possibility of an agreement between Anna Abrams and the Palmers about transfer of interest in the safe. Do you recall that question?
Yes, I recall.
If that were to happen, would you expect that the Palmers would have a combination to the safe?
Yes. Certainly, if I'm going to receive something like a safe, I would want to know how to open it.
And you're aware from your review of the materials in this case that when Mr. Schaefer found the safe, it doesn't have a handle or a dial on it?
I understand that it was destroyed, yes.
Now, the prosecutor asked you some questions about whether or not the certificates were technically lost as opposed to abandoned property.
Correct.
All right. And she specifically referred to your response to question 6, incorrectly stated as question number 4.
Yes.
Basically, what happened here, I asked you hypothetical questions and you provided your answers. Is that correct?
I did that. I did. That's correct.
Gave you assumptions and she read part of the last sentence in that. Do you have that in front of you?
Bear with me. Yes, sir. I have it now.
And you described lost property, correct? The second to the last sentence in that paragraph?
Yes.
And then she read that part that says, under the circumstances expressed above, logical conclusion to be reached is that the Abrams family left and forgot about the gold certificates. She read that part?
I read that, yes.
The sentence actually continues with, and Schaefer, as the finder of the property, became the owner?
Correct.
Is there anything in the question that the prosecutor asked you about, title 46:30C, that changes your opinion?
Not at all.
I have no further questions. We concluded, Your Honor.
Very well, thank you. May resume deliberations.